Hello friends, let's see the superficial fascia of the anterior abdominal wall. The superficial fascia of the anterior abdominal wall we can study under two headings. The fascia above the line joining the anterior superior iliac spine and the fascia below this line. The superficial fascia above the line joining the two anterior superior iliac spines, which is somewhere present here, and above that line the superficial fascia, it is of the single layer, and below this line the superficial fascia is divided into two layers. These are the superficial fatty layer, and it is also called as superficial fatty layer of the Camper's fascia, and the deeply situated membranous layer, and that layer it is called as the deep membranous layer or the fascia of the scarpa. Between these two layers, the superficial fatty layer of the camper and the deep membranous layer of the scarpa, we find three branches of the femoral artery which are superficial, and these are the superficial circumflex iliac artery, superficial epigastric artery, and superficial external pudendal artery. Along with this, three accompanying are also present, and these are the tributaries of the great saphenous vein. Along with these three superficial vessels, the superficial inguinal lymph nodes, they are also present just near the inguinal ligament. Now when we see the superficial fatty layer of the camper, it is going to continue with the subcutaneous fat of the adjacent areas, and over the scrotum this fatty tissue, it is going to replaced by the involuntary deltoid muscle, which is actually the continuation of the deep membranous layer. So with the scrotum, the deltoid muscle, it is the replacement of the both the superficial fatty and the deep membranous layer of the superficial fascia. When we see the fascia of the scarpa, the scarpa's fascia, this is the deep membranous layer, and this is important layer for the lower abdomen because it is going to continue with the fundiform ligament of the penis in the midline. So here on the figure of the right side, this is the deep membranous layer of the scarpa, and this deep membranous layer in the midline, it is going to continue with this ligament, and this ligament is the fundiform ligament of the penis. This fundiform ligament of the penis, above it is attached with the linea alba, and below it is going to split into two layers to wrap around the fascia of the penis, and then continue with the septum of the scrotum. And just deep to this fundiform ligament of the penis, one more ligament is present, and this is the suspensory ligament of the penis, which is above attached with this symphysis pubis, and below it is going to wrap with the deep fascia of the penis. This deep membranous layer or the scarpa's fascia, it is also continuous with the deltoid muscle of the scrotum. Over the inguinal ligament, this membranous layer, it is going to blanch with the fascia lata of the thigh. So this is all about the superficial fascia of the anterior abdominal wall. When we see the superficial inguinal space here on the sagittal section, in this figure we can see the gap between the deep membranous layer of the scarpa and the anterior abdominal wall muscle, that is the external oblique muscle. That space, it is called as the superficial inguinal space, and this space ultimately it is continue with the superficial inguinal pouch, which we have already discussed in our video series of the perineum. The deep fascia of the anterior abdominal wall is said to be absent in the anterior abdominal wall because it is formed by collagenous fibrous membrane, which is non-elastic and which might prevent bulging of the anterior abdominal wall.